Hi folks, Ty was here. We are having a look at the Curious Expedition today, which is much better than the Non-Curious Expedition. They just sort of went out and had a look, found it all a bit dull and went home. But here today, we're here to look around, see new things, and cover new worlds with some of history's most famous figures. So, without no more faffing around, we'll just get stuck into the game. Alright, so this is the first time I've played it, first time I've opened it up, so I haven't made any progress. I'm assuming these are unlocked as you progress and get various achievements done. Ah, here you go. Yeah, so basically you can unlock these other figures by doing these sorts of things. But anyways, we've got Darwin. And yeah, so these are the companions they start with, which convey various benefits. Well, just to set things on fire, that's a pretty good way to start. Okay, and he has a gun and a machete. Well, that is a pretty good way to start an expedition. And let's see. Okay, so this guy's advantage seems to be that he gets a long way. Charles Darwin's advantage, is it his scientific background? No, it's his ability to collect butterflies and shoot things. So the warrior carrying things, and Richard Francis Burton. Okay, so fighter and scouting. Right, but he doesn't have a gun. Good old Marie Curie. Oh, she actually starts with two animals. That is pretty OP. Okay, polymath. Choose from 5 perks as opposed to 3. Now, that's one of two things. Either you get to start the game with 5 perks. What I think it's more like is that when you level up, you get a list of perks to choose from, and she gets to pick from 5 as opposed to 3. Let's see. Okay, she has a bullet, or bullets, but doesn't have a gun. But she has a donkey and a dog and a missionary. I think I'm gonna go with Darwin. Yeah. Got a translator, so interacting with indigenous tribes that I suspect will be useful. And yeah, Scotsman. And a gun, of course. Plus fire, I mean. Oh, everyone gets a star fire, but whatever. Anyways, Darwin it is. See, welcome back to the Explorers Club, dear friend. Have you heard that we are building a statue to honor our most famous member? Rumor is that you have a good chance of seeing your likeness in that statue. However, I'm afraid to tell you you're not the only candidate. You and your rivals have 6 expeditions to prove who is the most famous explorer within our club. Now go explore, adventure awaits. I'm guessing this is the difficulty. I'm tempted, because I know people are watching and I don't want to sound like a wussy, but you know what, I'm going to start an expedition. I think the creators created a Flash version of this. I vaguely remember playing a Flash version of this in Newgrounds many years ago. And I saw this, you know, for sale, so I thought I'd check it out. Anyways, expedition, let's go. well, we're spoiled for choice. I want to go to the Merciless Jungle. Let's see. Alright, so yeah, various regions, locations, money. Alright, so yeah, I guess we're going to the old jungle. Eagerly anticipating the forthcoming adventure, I boarded the ship. We had little time before the ship would be ready, so I took some pleasure in envisioning my name in the newspapers. An affluent foreigner named Sir D'Elmied greeted me. He explained that he originated from the area we were heading to before coming to England with the crew. He had thereafter settled and invested here and requested that I find his wife in this former village and escort her to London. Well, you are just a smash-up husband, mate. Yeah, sure, we'll find your wife. I can't promise you'll be alive. I mean, I'll certainly try, but I accepted his request to find his internist wife, you know, thankfully, and wished us luck. At long last, our ship was ready to sail. Great. Onwards and upwards, tally-ho, ching-ching, queen and country, all that jazz. Got a little boat. And where do you want to go? Okay. Oh dear. The fake choice. Yeah, you can go somewhere, but you've got to do an intro screen first. Let's see. Yeah, refill water. Oh, no, you don't. Oh, man, that's brutal. I mean, I can imagine someone starting this game and making the reasonable assumption that you're setting out with water. But in fact, if you don't... Oh, and you've got to do it multiple times too. Don't you think it's enough water? No way. I mean, we can always ditch it if need be. Yeah, I'm just going to stack up on water. Because worst case scenario is I have to throw it away. Well, assuming, of course, there is a means with which to... Oh, wait, is that overburdened? Don't you think it's enough water? I suspect it is. Yeah, all right. Access the ship's storage. Is there anything worthwhile? Nope. All right, let's go. Okay, I'm not going to bother reading. Yeah, it just occurred to me that whenever other YouTubers do that, it annoys the hell out of me. So I'm just going to play and make observations. All right, so I guess that, notice how like when I'm on here, it's like a little X, but this is like a black sort of line. It actually looks like a machete, and I suspect that is, you know, indicate it's rough terrain. So it looks like the pathfinding picks the most optimal route. So what are these little icons here? Escort villager to... Alright. Oh, and he's an alcoholic. Alright, and... superstitious. This temple is cursed. And we can mount the donkey? One item... dismount? Oh, okay. Oh, I see, because he carries things. So if you mount the donkey, he can carry less. But then again, we already started with shitloads of water, so what if... Okay, yeah, great. So I'm not too sure what advantage mounting a donkey has, but we'll just do that. It might be a terrible decision. Anyways, let's get on with the freaking game already. Alright, examine. Alright, so it seems like we can either take the loot or we can leave it. Now, she's superstitious. Which is very unfortunate because I'm absolutely going to take this stuff. Oh, whatever, shut up. We'll be fine. Yeah, and when we come back to England and we're crazy successful, you'll be eating your fruit. More overburdened. Yeah, fine. Just bin it. It's okay. Alright. I suppose this village is a good a place to go as any. Let's do it. Alright. This is sanity, I think? Like, I remember, like you might recall when we were having a look at the intro, there was booze, which, if, you know, fixed sanity. So I'm guessing, yeah, the more you explore, the more crazy you get. How your trackers perceive, they may act silly. Okay, so may not want to take stuff all the time. Piece of cake. Can we recruit anyone? I like that. They didn't trust us. It was like, I changed my mind anyway. It's like, whatevs. But we've got Lady with us now. So she can help carry stuff. But do we have anything to offer? I don't... I mean, normally I just trade the booze. Yeah, apparently the Scotsman's a booze hound. I think that's a little bit racist, but anyway. Food... What does it actually do? Delicious, but they spoil quickly. I'm glad I read that. So, on one hand, I kind of think it'd be good to hang on to it for food, but if it spoils quickly, probably best to trade it for something that doesn't spoil, because then we could always trade that thing that doesn't spoil for food later on. A horn flute, distracting wildlife, rope. Makes a good trading item. Look, I've got a feeling that rope is going to be useful. Health item. Is there like a... See, it says like value 2, value 10, and it's got this thing, this sort of graphical user interface to indicate the terms of the trade. I mean, graphical user interface is good because you can just look at it and get an idea of where the trade is at rather than having to go like, oh, okay, what's all these numbers and do a bunch of maths in your head. But it would be nice if there were some numbers somewhere just so you could, you know, get a bit of an idea where you're at. Holy crap, they really love these mangoes. I'm getting an awesome trade for this. What's this? Will improve the loyalty of a person if gifted. I feel like loyalty is going to be important. How much? Frick it. They will stand by me or they will die. And great. Oh, no deal. Ah, fine. Whatever. Fine. Okay, if I rest in the village, what does that do? A rash is clearly visible in their neck and... Oh, no! Do I hug them? Because, I mean, you know, when you're adventuring in the wild, I mean, the thing is that natives will usually build up resistance to the things in the area and will be able to, you know, fight it off earlier. Like, it's like the common thing, you know, don't drink the local water. It's fine for the locals because they're used to it. But if you're a foreigner, then you're going to catch everything. Visible rash. Should I allow the hug? Yeah, you know what? Fuck it. Let's do it. let's see. Minus two standing. Well, doesn't seem like, doesn't seem like anything too bad happened. And, you know, obviously they didn't have a problem with me stealing mangoes. I mean, I went to the shrine, I took the mangoes, I then traded the mangoes, and they're like, yeah, that's great. So obviously there is absolutely no problem. We can loot those shrines a-okay. Can't climb mountains by the looks of things. If I just go next to it. Oh, yes, got a rash. What's the rash? An unsightly affliction. Well, we'll see. Level up characters. Can I? What's this? Like? Oh, maybe you have to do it like in a... oh, you can... Oh, okay, so you can bail out if you want to. And there's a cave. Yeah, can I explore the cave? Oh, yeah. Yeah, how about the big button in the middle that says explore cave? Man, I am so good at games. Explore in the darkness. Yeah, you know what? Just light a fire. Let's do it. Click mushrooms. Loot. Take all the mushrooms. Overburdened. Came on from numerous afflictions. Testless problems seem to be gone for a moment. Some, that sounds like sanity. Healing abilities. Rash. I've got a... Oh, wait, hang on. Promote. Yeah, because, I mean, he is... So I don't get to get a promotion? Oh, whatever. Alright. Strangely arranged sticks. Let's check it out. Okay, that doesn't seem to be anything particularly important. I do need to get rid of something. Give mushroom, yeah, get rid of that rash. Wait, what? What's the shaman? Promote? No, it doesn't work. Alright. You know, I'm just going to get off the donkey. That's fine. Alright. Let's have a look. Okay, so machetes are important. We started with 10, but we're already, like, through half of them. We've barely got through the adventure. Let's see. Examine the shrine. Yeah, absolutely. We're going to explore. Frickin' oath, it's a good idea. Why would you not say that? Whoa! Okay, so we messed up some stuff, but... look at that! That's great! Yeah, okay, so we might have devastated, a bunch of lands, but... nobody died, I don't think. And... okay, so let's eat that. Plus 10 sanity, plus 10 sanity, great. Alright, so this is where we're at the moment. Okay, so it doesn't go up and down, just kind of up a little bit, but you know, not really enough to make it noteworthy. Right, let's just pick it. Okay, well, this seems to be ocean, so we're gonna head inland. Let's see. Okay, so there's some angry animals. Oh, wait, there's something there. Loyalty decrease. But, dude, you got the booze? Oh, unless it's because I actually have to drink it. Okay. That makes you feel better. Man! That's a lot of sanity. But, I just think it's funny because, I mean, that much sanity gain would suggest that alcohol is the sort of go-to way to restore sanity. But we'll see. An old campsite of a failed expedition. Yeah, I think it's worthwhile exploring. Well, we got chocolates. Refill some sanity. Only enjoyable to a certain degree. Oh dear. Yeah, we'll just eat a bunch of chocolate. Hell will freeze over before I eat any more of that. No one likes the beans. I'm guessing they're a trade item. See, they're worth 5%. Yeah, nothing. But it seems like no one likes those, and they've got no use. So off you go. Let's check out. Wow, really? That's a. Yep, whatever. Right, so I think it'll be worthwhile stacking up on the machetes because they seem incredibly useful. Mosquitoes. Is that like catch mosquitoes? Maybe it means you'll. I think this is the Gold Temple. Now, if I recall correctly from when I played it way back when, this is sort of like the objective. Alright, sweet. Because we found the Golden Pyramid. Because we got there first. Okay, so speed is super important. It got more than double than for actually reaching the destination. So, okay, so yeah, good way to emphasize speed as opposed to exploring the whole bloody map on the off chance you might find something. Choose a perk. That seems pretty handy. That is interesting. Viewing distance. All right, well, yeah, movement's obviously important, but knowing where the hell you're going is also important. I think the jungle movement is, because that is just everywhere. Oops. Oh, what? Oh, okay. Oh, I see. So I can either sell it, or keep it as a gift. Yeah, I'm gonna donate that to museum. And I've got that other one too. Yeah, absolutely gift that. The hang on those things was absolutely worth it, and robbing that temple was a good idea. Oh, so now we actually have choices. Well balanced wide grasslands. Well, I just got the jungle perk. I do feel a little ripped off. Because I just suddenly realized that not every area might make use of the jungle perk. But anyways, let's see. I better get a damn reward. Oh, cool. Somebody is always missing. A trader? A soldier? A Bedouin. Desert explorable. I'm not going to the desert anytime soon. To steal objects. get 70 from fighting. Okay, so he's kind of a... I mean, the trader sort of sounds like a good idea. Doesn't carry that much. I think Corporal Edward might be the way to go, primarily because he doesn't have a weakness. Sure. Animal improvement. Mr. Overton's name is Donkey. That's great. Yes, because that means we can carry more stuff home. Purchase equipment. I wonder if that's a consumable. Yeah, machetes are absolutely worth it. Need to dig things up. I'm sure some of these are useful. Not worth anything. Alright. Didn't get much use out of that rope, actually. Oh, I see, you can't trade. Which makes sense. You can imagine, you know, going into like a provision store and then, you know, you say like, oh, I'll have these machetes, please. And they're like, well, that'll be $50. And you're like, will you accept this rope instead? And they'll say, no, I'll accept $50. Thank you. All right. So what's this other stuff? Oh, look, I'm sure it's all useful, but it will have to wait. I went for the fame instead of the money. We'll see how that goes. Alright, so that's about as good as it gets. Now, my character's had a rash before I left. I'm not sure if it will still be there. Alright, doing the tricky intro. Well, we got 20 water and did not use any of it. Ship storage. Do I want to store anything? Nah, not really. Let's just go. Now. Let's carry using region points. Who? Did I promote anyone? I seem... Because I remember we've got those... whatever. But yeah, don't seem to be having a rash, so it's fine. Let's start by heading there. It's as good a place as any. Old campsite. It's like, please bring my husband home. He's just like a guy who's been out in the boons for freaking ages and is ready to snap. Okay. Yeah. Absolutely ready to snap. Increase sanity when resting in villages, which is handy. Sanity from fighting. Increase sanity from drinking whiskey. That, I mean, that's kind of handy actually, because healing lacks booze. So as long as I keep the booze up, that will be fine. Alright, so how come I could promote her but not him? Well, anyway, life goes on. Let's continue exploring. Alright, what do we got? Look at that! We call this the Dupixton. It seems to be a... yeah. It's... oh, bongo drums. Let's see. It's only minus one. It's fine. It's fine. Removed after expedition. Alright, well, if they're going to be removed, might as well make the most of them now. I'm just going to move short distances because it doesn't seem... because clicking over here and then, you know, instantly revealing, say, something to explore there, I would feel pretty dumb. Yeah, there's something over there. We'll just... moosey on over there. Is that a fucking dinosaur? Just focus on stuff. Yes, gifts. Hey, guys. actually, hang on a second. Yeah, no one gives a shit about water, apparently. If you give them lots, it, actually increases your standing. Of course, I'm not going to do that, but worthwhile learning that you can buy friends. Can be traded in for fame. What the hell? Oh, puppets! As opposed to children. That's good. How much use for rope? The reason I want to get that is because I'm going to be looting a lot of idols, and I suspect my translator is going to get unimpressed very quickly. Value funds 5 back, so I can pay 10 and get 5 back. No, you'd only get it for fame, but it's bugger all fame. No, I'll take the necklace and trade you some rope and some bongo drums. Does anyone want to join? They don't trust us. of course. It's not that they didn't trust us. I changed my mind. Alright. So that's the village. Sticks. Let's have a look around here. Remember the one I played a while ago? Like, the map was very squarish. Don't mind you, later expeditions, I'm suspecting this map kind of area will expand, but it was a bit hard to have an idea of which direction exactly you're supposed to be heading. It feels like I'm getting into like a corner here, so I'm gonna head back this way. We'll head up just straight up. Let's do it. Shrine. Yes, let's go into the shrine. Oh, sorry. The donkey's just chilling out in the stairs. Yes, we are taking that. We took and proceeded as a plant left behind us began to wither and die. We are bad people. The reason is because it's what it's saying is you need 2 star points to upgrade it, right? Not as opposed to, I don't know what the hell I was thinking. Anyway, so is there a way to tell your, like, check your person's loyalty? There must be, surely. Really? No. Go there. I can see why the natives hate us. And I can't say it's wrong. A portal? Absolutely enter the portal. We'd be crazy not to. What the actual fuck? Sanity is not doing great. Let's do some booze. Explore the springs. Yeah, let's rest overnight. We need to recover some sanity. Right. That worked, didn't it? So let me get this straight, dude. You... Yeah, basically, I'm returning to your wife, and you're the one cracking a shit about her saying to you... Whatever. Though he is actually a cannibal, isn't he? Yeah, what's up? Oh, we are horrible people. Horrible people. And the portal is back there. Oh, no. I think... We might just have to... Oh, no! She's gone! The translator is gone! This is a disaster. Oh, no! Well, she will be missed. I just hope that fire does burn out eventually. Oh, okay, so it's like a limited time thing. Alright. So my Persian translator has literally been lost in time and space. That is pretty awesome. If you have to go, that is a not bad way to go. Now, I've been avoiding these guys because it looked like, you know, monsters, hostile, whatever. We're gonna have a go. Frick it. We've already lost one person. What's the worst that can happen? Yeah, let's fight this thing. We're gonna do it. Yeah, absolutely attack. Alright. Allows a special... Oh, okay. Right. Let's see. Guessing that's nothing. That's to run away. Oh my gosh. Am I going to die? I think this is... Oh, I am the world's biggest idiot. Alright, so how it actually works is you roll the dice, and then you sort of... Okay, so raptors are freaking dangerous. Alright, so that's kind of it. It's got a little bit of roguelike essence to it in that, I probably could have played the tutorial, but, you know, it's much more fun just to dive headed person. Anyway, so it seems like the idea is to kind of explore around, a little bit of like an FTLE type vibe where you'll go explore things and you've got to make a decision whether or not you want to take the benefit and, you know, if the potential cost is going to outweigh it. Yeah, not too bad. I'll probably take it for another spin at another point, but for this video, I think we're done. Thanks for watching and see you next time.